Friends, how are you? Hope you all are busy in your preparation for your half yearly examination. Yes, you are doing good job. Students, in this video, I am explaining some programs and I have given some theoretical part also. So you will prepare that program which I have given in this video and my previous video. And the theoretical part also. Let's start. Using stream class. This is a chapter number 5, input in Java. To input a value by using input stream reader class, use the following steps. We are using two types of input stream reader and by the scanner class. First, I am telling you about the stream class. First, input stream reader class is available in Java IO package. Hence, first of all, we need to import this package by using the statement import.java.io. This is used for the input stream reader classes. Now, in the main function, create object of input stream reader and buffer reader class as shown below. Input stream reader read new is equal to new input stream reader read is equal to new input stream reader system dot in. We are using two lines in place of scanner in is equal to new scanner system dot in. We will use these two lines for in place of that one line. So nowadays we are using scanner classes. The object names like read and in can be any word as per the user's choice. Now I am telling you the different types of values can be input in the following ways. First is integer. When we are using integer value, we will use int n. System out print ln enter a number. If we are using integer, then first we will enter a number. After that, we will write the data type. N is equal to integer dot parse in dot read line. This type of data we will use in input stream reader classes. Decimal double n system out println enter a number n is equal to double dot parse double in dot read line. But nowadays when we are making a program in place of this integer dot parse in, we will use in dot next int, then in line. Now float fraction or decimal int n. For float we are using float. Character we will use in dot read line. String means a set of character word, string str. System out println enter a string str is equal to in dot read line. This we will use for the buffer readers stream classes. Now using scanner class. Nowadays when we are making a program and we are writing a program, we will use scanner classes method. To input a value by using scanner class, we will use the scanner class is a member or java.util.package. Hence, first of all, we need to import this package by using the statement import java.util. And we can use this also import java.scanner.terminator. When we are creating object of scanner class in the main function, then we will use scanner sc is equal to new scanner system.in. The value of different data types can be input by using next. There we are using integer.parse, but here we are using next functions of scanner class. The different types of values can be input in the following ways. Integer in n, system out print and enter a number, then we will write the data type in dot next in. System out, when we are using double n, then enter a number, then we will use n is equal to in dot next double. Float fractional or decimal value int n, here we will use the data type in dot next float. Character only one character, A, B, C, only one character. Then we will use cat ch Then data type is ch is equal to in dot next line. String, a set of character or word. String str, system out println, enter a string. Ch is equal to in dot next line. Using command line argument. This is one of the way to accept the data values from the user and pass the argument to the main function while expecting the values from the console. The system stores the data values in different location as an array or string. This we will use for array. To input a value by using scanner class, use the following step. Use a string type array argument as an argument to the main functions. This is public static main, string args or string args. We will write like this also, and we will write this also. This bracket we will use after string and after argument. Both are the same. The different types of value can be input in the following ways. Int n is equal to integer dot parse argument 0. Decimal n is equal to system out printer enter a number double dot parse double argument 0. Float fractional, float dot parse, float argument 0. Character ch is equal to argument 0. Then in string str is equal to argument 0, place of 0. Now I am explaining, there are some types of error also. Errors is the mistakes which we have done by grammatical, by any logical or by any runtimes. This type of when this type of condition applied incorrect input data, this is known as the error. So in simple language, when we run a program, then it may not get the desired result due to incorrect input data, and hence some errors arises. There are three types of errors in a computer program. First is syntax error. These errors occur due to the grammatical errors in the programming language. When any grammatical mistakes in the program, that is known as the syntax error. Logical error, the error which occurs in the programming logic is known as logical error. Logic means we have used greater than, equal than, equal equal, less than, not equal. When this type of sign we are using, then this is known as the logical error. And sign, or sign, this is known as the logical error. This type of error is known as the logical error. Runtime error. It is a type of error that occurs at runtime when the compiler does not respond properly while executing a statement. Suppose we have made a program and when we want to compile that program and computer does not respond, that is known as this type of error is known as the runtime error. So there are three types of errors: syntax error, logical error, and runtime error. Now comment statement in Java programming. What is comment? Comment in a program make it more readable for the user. There are three types of comment. Comments, we will use this comments before starting the programs when we are using this type of comment. First is single line comment. It is a single line comment. A single line comment start with the double slash followed by the message. For example, we will write double slash a program to find the sum of two numbers, a program to find the subtract of two numbers, a program to find the simple interest of the given principal rate and time. This type of message is known as the single line comment. Now second is multiple line comment. When we are using more than one line, that is known as the multiple line comment. It is way to present more information about programs to explain the logic in details. A multi-line comment start with forward slash and that asterisk sign followed by the comment lines and ends with asterisk and forward slash. A program, so for example, first we will write a program to calculate discount. It will calculate, this program is calculating discount. it accept the market price and discount present as inputs. So there we are using more than one line, so that this is known as the multi-line comment. Now next is documentation comment. It is not a discussion about the program logic, but includes some text document. This comment starts with forward slash, two asterisk, followed by the set of commands, comment lines, and ends with two multiplication sign, and one is, suppose we are writing like this. This is author name Amit Kumar, starting date of project this, completion date of project this. We will use two here. Two asterisk sign we will use. I have written by mistake, I have written one sign here, but you will write two sign. This is the documentation comment, which is giving the information about a person whose name is Amit Kumar and who his date of project is this and completion date of project is this. Now I have explained you the syntax error and comments and the input in Java. Hope you understood. In my previous video, I have explained some programs and I have given you some programs. You will do that programs, you will practice for that programs, and you will do the theories. And in this video, I have explained this because I have explained little much about these in my previous video. So I have explained completely in this video. Now you will try to do this and try to do the programs. If you have any problem, you can ask me. I have given some theoretical questions also in your home assignment. You will learn that questions and you will do that question. If you have any problem about that question, then you can ask me through mail. All the best for your half-yearly exam. Thank you.